The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 2nd Chapter, text number 18, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on August 21st, 1972, in Los Angeles.
Translation: by regularly hearing the Bhagavatam and rendering service unto the pure devotee, all that is troublesome to the heart is practically destroyed. And loving service unto the glorious Lord, who is praised with transcendental songs, is established as an irrevocable fact.
So, here it is said, Bhagavata Sevaya, not Bhagavan Sevaya. Bhagavan is Krishna, this Supreme Personality of Godhead. And Bhagavat means in relation with Bhagavan. Who has got relationship with Bhagavan. So here it is recommended Bhagavata Sevaya, not Bhagavan Sevaya. The idea is that you cannot approach Bhagavan, God, directly. That is not possible. First of all, you have to serve Bhagavata, the devotee. Bhagavata, there are two kinds of Bhagavata. Book Bhagavata and devotee Bhagavata. So, in the Shiva Purana, there is a question by Parvati to Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva and Parvati, husband and wife. Parvati means the material nature. Sisti sthiti palaya sadhana shaktirika chhai vajasa bhavanani vibharti Durga. Durga Devi. Durga Devi is in charge of this material world. It is called Durga. Durga just like fort. And the superintendent of this fort is Durga. You cannot go out of this fort. You are imprisoned. So such Durga Devi, who is so powerful energy, she can create, annihilate, maintain. Srishti sthiti palaya sadhana. She is always sitting by the side of her husband, Lord Shiva, and questioning about spiritual inquiries. You see, such powerful deity is also ignorant about spiritual life. So the husband, Lord Shiva, is Vaishnava, and she is always asking, and sitting down underneath a bale tree, she can create so many universes. But for her, no building, only underneath a tree. So the question was, which worship is best? So Lord Shiva replied, Aradhananam sarvesham Vishnu aradhanam param. My dear Parvati, of all methods of worship, Vishnu worship is the topmost. There are many demigods worship, even Lord Shiva's worship, but Lord Shiva says, Vishnu worship is the best. Then he says again, Tasmat Paratanam Devi, my dear Devi, better than that Vishnu worship is Tadiyanam Aradhanam. Tadiya, Tadiya means those who are in relationship with Vishnu. Tadiya, just like his devotee. Tadiya, Tulsi Viksha, Tulsi is Tadiya. A temple, Tadiya. Preaching, Tadiya. Tadiyanam Aradhanam. This is Bhagavata. So, Lord Shiva recommends that of all methods of worship, Vishnu worship is the best. And better than Vishnu worship is to worship his devotee or things in relationship with him. Tridhyana, that is Bhagavata. Here it is also said, Tadiyanam Bhagavata Sivaya. This book Bhagavata, spoken by the devotee Bhagavata, this should be taken very seriously daily. Otherwise, we do not understand what is Bhagavata. Therefore it is recommended here, Nityam. Daily or constantly, 24 hours. We have to mold our life in such a way that 24 hours, not a single moment living aside, we should be engaged in Bhagavata Sivaya, in the service of Lord's relationship. Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita, the spiritual master, Tulsi Devi, the temple, the preaching, the books, these are all Bhagavata. So Nityanga Bhagavata Seva. Nashta Pravasa. If we engage ourselves in this Bhagavata Seva, just like we are doing daily, trying to read one verse of Srimad Bhagavatam, discussing amongst ourselves, this is Bhagavata Seva. Nityam, daily, regularly. By this process, when the dirty things within the heart, nashta prayesu abhadreshu, abhadra means dirty things, inauspicious things. What is that inauspicious thing? Inauspicious things means the heart disease for sense enjoyment. This is inauspicious. Different varieties of Abhadreshu. There are three modes of material nature, and multiply it three, mix it again, it becomes nine, and again multiply it nine by nine, it becomes 81. So this originally the three, just like three color, yellow, red and blue. These three colors you mix, those who are artists, those who know the color display, simply you mix three colors in different way and it becomes varieties of color. So our heart disease, dirty thing, varieties of sense enjoyment. Varieties. So heart is full with varieties of sense enjoyment. Therefore, by Nityanga Bhagavata Sivaya, by daily, regular worshipping Bhagavatam, we become free from the dirty things. In the previous verse we have read that Sinnatang Sakata Krishna Punnasavana Kirtana Riddhantastha Abhadrani. We have got Abhadrani, so many inauspicious things within our heart. This can be cleansed simply by hearing the message of Krishna from Srimad Bhagavatam, from Bhagavad Gita, from the lips of devotees. In this way, when almost the dirty things are cleared out. Not all. As soon as all dirty things are cleared out, then we are liberated soul. Immediately love of God, the original consciousness. He become mad, just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Juga itam nimishina chakshusha pravishayitam sunna itam jagat sadvam govinda virahina. Feeling separation of Govinda. How one moment is equal to 12 years, jugaitam. One juga means 12 years. one moment appearing. Sometimes we have got experience. If we want to see something, it is called expectant psychology. I am expecting something, somebody, that my friend or my lover is coming. So on the door, if there is khut, oh, you have come? No, he has not come. The whole moment is 12 years. Such kind of separation, when we feel for Krishna, that means all dirty things are over. And something for Krishna, something for sense enjoyment, that means still the dirty things are there. But the more we engage our time, nityam bhagavata sevaya, the dirty things becomes clean gradually. Just like when you are hungry, you are given food stuff, you eat. The more you eat, your hunger is satisfied. You feel strength, you feel satisfaction. Similarly, the more you advance in Krishna consciousness, you feel comfortable, released from the material discomforts. In this way, not of price, gradual process. Not of price, swavadrishu nittanga bhagavata sevaya. Not all cleans, but prior, say 75 cleans. At that time, you become fixed up in devotional service. Nice. There are different stages of devotional service that I have explained several times. First of all, sraddha, sadhu sangha, vajana kriya, anartha nivitti syat. When anartha nivitti syat, all unwanted things are finished, at that time nishtha, firm faith. So bhagavati uttama sloke bhakti bhavati naishthiki. So long there are dirty things, our faith and devotion in Krishna is not very fixed up. Sometimes we deviate, we go away. Nasta prayasu, when 75% of the dirty things are cleansed, then our faith in God becomes fixed up. Bhagavati uttama sloka. Uttama. Uttama means udgata tama. This material world is tama, ignorance, darkness. And Krishna is beyond this material world. Therefore he is called para. Para means transcendental. So uttama sloka. So when we offer our prayers to Krishna, they are not ordinary words. Therefore those who are not liberated soul, they cannot offer prayers actually. We have to repeat the prayers offered by liberated soul, not by ordinary man. Because he is not yet uttama, he is not yet in the transcendental platform. Therefore we don't allow songs which are not sung by liberated soul. Like Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Narottam Das Thakur. They are liberated soul. We don't allow any literature which is not given by liberated soul. Literatures, they are always following Vedic principles. Vedas, the original transcendental literature. And any literature which is produced under the guidance of Vedic literature, that is asanai, that is perfect. Therefore, whenever we write something, we give immediately Vedic evidence. We give some Sanskrit verse. This means that we are not manufacturing ourselves. What we have heard from the parampara system, from higher authorities, we are presenting simply in our own language. And the evidence is this Vedic verse. This is perfect literature. So, whimsically, we cannot write any poetry for Krishna. That is not possible. That will create havoc. Srila Rupa Goswami says, Shruti Sriti Puranadi Pancha Ratriki Vidhi Vina Vaikandiki Harir Bhakti Utpata Eva Kalpate. Any devotional sentiment which is not supported by Vedas, Shruti, Shruti means Veda, and Smriti means corollary to the Veda, things which are written in corroboration with the Vedic ideas, that is called Smriti. Just like Bhagavad Gita is Smriti. Bhagavad Gita, the purpose of Bhagavad Gita is the same as the Veda, but it is not directly Veda. That is called Smriti, Shruti Smriti, Puranadi. The Puranas, there are 18 Puranas. Puranadi means Ramayana Mahabharata also. Shruti Smriti Puranadi. Pancharatriki Vidhi Vina. Pancharatriki Vidhi, given by Narad Muni for worshipping the deity. We are worshipping the deity under the Pancharatriki Vidhi. So, Rupa Goswami says that any devotional service which has no reference with Shruti, Sriti, Puran, Pancha, that is simply disturbance. Simply disturbance, creating disturbance. We cannot manufacture. Sometimes we are questioned, can he do this, can he do that? Of course it is good. But there is no need of manufacturing some idea. Whatever idea is already there, follow strictly. So, Bhagavati Uttama Sloke Bhakti Bhavati Nashtiki. That fixed up bhakti is required, not oscillating. Sometimes this side, sometimes that side. So, this can be possible. Fixed up devotional service by Nityang Bhagavata Sevaya. Regularly worshipping the Bhagavad Grantha and the devotee, Bhagavad. Because without hearing about God authentically, how we can fix up? So we should hear. Sinnatang Sakatha Krishna. Sakatha Krishna. Krishna's word is given by Krishna. Just like Bhagavad Gita. Sakatha means his own words. This is Bhagavad. And Sakatha, Srimad Bhagavatam is also Sakatha. The Purana is also Sakatha. Because all these books are given by Vyasadeva. Vyasadeva is incarnation of Krishna. So that is also Sakatha. So we have to hear about Krishna, which is given by Krishna. Bhagavad Gita is given by Krishna. And Bhagavat and other Puranas and Vedic literature given by Krishna Dvaipayana Vyas. And the method is taught by Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu. So therefore everything is Krishna's. Krishna directly, Krishna as Vyasadev, Krishna as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu devotee. So we have to follow this. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda, Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sivasadi Gaur Bhakti. Krishna is teaching how to approach Krishna. That is one of them. We cannot take any other method. This is the authorized method. The person concerned, he is teaching how to worship Krishna, how to become devotee. Krishna, Krishna Chaitanya Namini. Rupa Goswami said, Lord Chaitanya, you are Krishna, but you have appeared as Krishna Chaitanya. Krishna, Krishna Chaitanya Nami. Namo Mahavadanaya. Krishna Prema Pradayat. You are distributing love of Krishna. How it is possible for ordinary man? Krishna, but because you are Krishna, simply you are in the name of Krishna Chaitanya. So therefore, you can distribute. Your thing, you can distribute. Prasannatāṁ sakatā Krishna punna savana kirtana riddhantastha avadrāṇī vidhūnati suhi sadā nasta prāyesu avadreshu. A little, maybe, not all, there may be some habitual, but still, even there are some flaws in the beginning. If we fix up our devotion to Krishna, that is also confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita. Apiche sudurachara bhajati mamanannabha sadhuriva samantabhya sammak bhavasitahisa hiprang bhavati dharmatma sasat shanti nivacchati kontiya pratijani hi nami bhakta pranasati. So, in the beginning, we must be sincere, very sincere, to follow the rules and regulations. But due to our past habits, if there is some flaw, that is excused. Not intentionally, because I am habituated to something, and I am also engaged in Krishna consciousness, my past habit sometimes becomes manifest. So Krishna says, all right, you try your best, it will be rectified. Kiprang bhavati dharmat. Kiprang means very soon. He will be dharmatma, perfect, religious. Kiprang dhamati bhavati dharmatma sasat shanti nigacchati. And he elevated to the eternal platform of peace and tranquility. Kondeya pratijani hi namai bhakta pranasati. If one is sincere devotee, he will be not lost. He will make progress. But if there is any ulterior motive, then he will be lost. Maya is there. The Maya, just like shadow and light, they are side by side. A little crossing the marginal line between shadow and light, you are in the darkness. Similarly, a little crossing of the marginal line from the darkness to light, you are in light. So, Krishna and Maya are side by side. As soon as you forget Krishna, or as soon as you want to utilize Krishna for your sense gratification, it is immediately Maya, darkness. And as soon as you want to serve Krishna, immediately it is light. So if we keep ourselves on this side, light side, always serving Krishna, then there is no possibility of our being in contact with Maya. Daividhyesa gunamayi mamo maya durataya mamivaja prapadante maya mitang tarantite. This maya is very strong. The same example yesterday we are giving. The sun, little deviation. the whole world, universe becomes frozen. And little deviates and the whole universe becomes ablaze. This is the position. Therefore our position is marginal. We are called marginal energy. We may be dark side or in the light side. So Krishna consciousness means to keep always in the light side. If we always think of Krishna by chanting Hare Krishna Mantra, then we shall keep ourselves on the light side. And as soon as we think of sense gratification, immediately we are on the dark side. We should be very cautious that we may not fall down on the dark side. We can keep ourselves in the light side by nityam bhagavata sevaya, simply studying Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita, try to understand, chanting Hare Krishna mantra, 24 hours, be engaged in this way, you will be on the light side. Read the part.
Here is the remedy for eliminating all inauspicious things within the heart, which are considered to be obstacles in the path of self-realization. The remedy is the association of the Bhagavatas. There are two types of Bhagavatas, namely the book Bhagavata and the devotee Bhagavata. Both the Bhagavatas are competent remedies, and both of them, or either of them, can be good enough to eliminate the obstacles. A devotee Bhagavata is as good as the book Bhagavata, because the devotee Bhagavata leads his life in terms of the book Bhagavata. And the book Bhagavata is full of information about the personality of Godhead and his pure devotees, who are also Bhagavatas. Bhagavata book and person are identical. The devotee Bhagavata is a direct representative of Bhagavan, the personality of Godhead. So by pleasing the devotee Bhagavata, one can receive the benefit of the book Bhagavata. Human reason fails to understand how by serving the devotee Bhagavata or the book Bhagavata, one gets gradual promotion on the path of devotion. But actually these are the facts explained by Srila Narada Deva, who happened to be a maidservant's son in his previous life.
Vedic literature, the meaning becomes revealed to a person who has got unflinching faith in God and the spiritual master. Just like Gaur Krishna Das Bhaji Maharaj, he was editor, but he became the spiritual master of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami. So the purport of the Vedic literature becomes revealed to a person who has got unflinching faith in God and spiritual master. Go on.
The maidservant was engaged in the menial service of the sages, and thus he also came into contact with them. And simply by associating with them and accepting the remnants of foodstuff left by the sages, the son of the maidservant got the chance to become the great devotee and personality, Srila Narada Deva. These are the miraculous effects of the association of Bhagavatas. And to understand these effects practically, it should be noted that by such sincere association of the Bhagavatas, one is sure to receive transcendental knowledge very easily.
So, our principle should be not to disassociate ourselves from the devotees. Narottamdas Thakur therefore sings, Tadera charana seva bhaktasane bar, janame janame mor ei obhilas. I desire birth after birth to serve the acharyas and to live with devotees. So now these associations, societies, is giving these two opportunities. You serve the purpose or the orders of the acharyas and live with devotees. Then you will be secure in devotional service. Tadero charana sevi bhaktasane bas. Bhaktasane bas is very important thing. Even there is little inconvenience, still we should stick to live with the devotees. Then we shall be profit. Go on.
And the result is that he becomes fixed in the devotional service of the Lord. The more progress is made in devotional service under the guidance of the Bhagavatas, the more one becomes fixed in the transcendental loving service of the Lord. The messages of the book Bhagavata, therefore, have to be received from the devotee Bhagavata, and the combination of these two Bhagavatas will help the neophyte devotee to make progress on and on.